So in the series of learning C programming, we are discussing file handling concepts in C. We have discussed how to read content of file and how to write something to a file, two modes, read and write mode, right? With the functions which are used to read and write the content of a file, right? But next we will discuss append mode in file handling, means a file is there in your computer, right? And you have some content on that file and you want to add more content in that existing file. Then how you will add, how you will append? For that you will have to open that file into append mode. See, if you open the file in read mode, means you can only read the content, you cannot write something to a file, right? You cannot add something. If you open the file in write mode, then yeah, obviously you can write something to a file, but the previous content, whatever content is there, that would be erased, means the content would be overwritten, right? But here the situation is you want to keep the previous content as well as you want to add some more content to a file. Then in which mode you will open a file? In append mode, right? So this mode we will discuss with the help of a program, right? And I'll show you practical also. But before that, I just want to tell you one thing. If you guys are appearing for GATE 2022 examination, then it's right time to start your revision and go for test series. So here, An Academy is conducting All India Mock Test for GATE 2022 aspirants in the month of January, every Sunday. So here you can complete your final revision with these mock tests. These are full length mock tests, so they will be covering the entire syllabus. And here these tests has been curated by their best educators at An Academy. So you will come to know the exam pattern and the type of questions being asked in the GATE exam, right? And you will experience actual exam like sitting there. And you will also get All India ranking. So you will come to know where you are standing among all the other learners from all over India. You can assess your preparation here, right? And after every mock test, you will get detailed video solutions by their experts. So you can identify your weak areas and you can improve according to that. And you can take these mock tests for free. One more thing, they are also going to conduct a combat on 9th of January at 11 a.m. And you can take this combat or this test for free, and this is live. So here you will get a chance to compete with thousands of learners from all over India, and you stand a chance to win up to 100% scholarship as well as some exciting prizes. And you can see your rank against all the others using the live leaderboard that would be updated after every question. And An Academy is also going to start a guidance program for ESC aspirants from 10th to 17th of January. Those who have cleared their written exam, now the challenge is to crack personal interview. So this guidance program is to help you to sail through the personal interview with ease. And you can register for this program for free. And they have also started a few batches for GATE 2023 and 2024 aspirants from 5th of January. So in this batch, they will be covering the entire syllabus, and you will get lectures on preparation strategy, some tips and tricks, practice questions, numericals, along with the detailed explanation of all the concepts. So use my code JKL10 to enroll in the free test and to get 10% discount in your plus paid subscriptions. So all the relevant links and the details I'll put in the description box of this video. If you are interested, you can go and check out. Now let's see how to append something to a file. See, now suppose this is a file. I have abc.txt file, and in this file already I have, suppose, Jenny. And I want to add here Khatri, maybe here only or in new line, it's up to you. Now how you will append this thing into this file? First of all, obviously we are going to open this file, right? So now in which mode you will open? Append mode. See, I'll show you through a program. In main function, first of all, obviously you are going to create a file pointer that we have discussed many times in previous videos, right? And I'm initializing this with null. Now what you want to append, okay, that thing I'm going to take into this string. I'm taking a string here. Buffer is length is 50. Now open the file, fopen. Name of the file is abc.txt, or you can provide the complete path if this file is not in the same directory. And you will open the file into A mode, append mode. If you will open in this read mode, you can only read the content, you cannot add something. If you will open in this write mode, then this Jenny would be erased, and if you want to add Khatri, then Khatri would be here, means the previous content would be erased, that would be overwritten, right? But that I don't want. I want Jenny also, previous content also, and the new content also, right? So we will open this file into append mode, right? Now we will check if fp is null, then means error, and exit one, right? If this is not the case, if fopen has successfully opened this file, right, into the main memory, then what will happen, just ask from the user printf, or you can take here also and enter the content you want to append in the file, right? And I'm taking this with get s function, right? Now how you will write here, we have taken that I want to add Khatri, this one. Now how you will put the content here? Simply, we have functions for writing something into file. We have f put c, f put s, f print f. Whatever function you want to use, you can use. F put c will add only one character, so you can put that thing into loop. That's it. Or you can use a f put s for a string, or you can use like f print f. Whatever function you want to use, you can use, right? Now first of all, you will provide here the file pointer, then the format specifier, then here in which variable we have the content you want to add in str. Suppose you want to add this into new line here, then just provide here slash n. If you will not write here slash n, then this Khatri would be added here only, Khatri, right? So it's up to you in which, where the location you want to add, new line or not, right? That's it. And simply you can print a message if you want to print like successfully appended. This would be printed on your screen, and after that obviously you will close the file, right? That's it. Now whenever this open function, if open function will open this file, the cursor would be automatically here in the last of the existing file. Means from here, now you are adding the file, or you will add the content, or you will append the content, right? Now in fprintf you are providing what? Slash n. So now cursor would be obviously here, and whatever is there in str, whatever content you will provide, right? This is what we are taking from the user, the input. Whatever content you will provide, that would be appended in the next line, right? And this message would be printed successfully appended. That's it, right? So it's very simple. If you will not use fprintf, rather than this you can use f put s, and simply you will provide what? In str we are having the content, comma, the file pointer fp. That's it. This will also do same thing. If you will use f put c, then that would add only single character, so put that f put c into a while loop. That's it. Or while loop or any loop, right? See now how this append mode is different from this write mode. If you will open this file into write mode or append mode, same thing is what? If file exists, okay, they will open the file. If file don't exist, both will create a new file. It will also create new file, it will also create new file, right? Same thing is this, similarity is this. But what is the dissimilarity? In W mode, the content would be overwritten. Suppose Jenny is there and I want to add Khatri. So first of all, Jenny would be erased and you will hear only Khatri if you will open this into write mode, right? Now Jenny is there in this file and I want to add Khatri, and you will open into this append mode, then simply that would be appended here. If you will not put slash n, if you will put slash n, then that would be appended in next line. That's it. In this case, f put s str fp, in this case this Khatri would be appended in the same line because there is no slash n here, right? So I hope now you got this concept, and you will also, you know, you also got that what is the difference between this write mode and append mode, right? Now let me show you practical of this program. Now let me create a new file for you, append file load c, right? Then in main function, first we will create file pointer fp is equal to null, and I am taking a string char str, right, 30, and just open the file f open abc.txt. I am opening this into append mode, right? Just check if fp is equal to null, then error, and simply exit from here only, right? But if this is not the case, then what we will do? Printf, enter the content you want to append. Just you will enter the content, and I am taking the function getS, simple using str, and I am writing here fputs. Using fputs I am writing str comma file pointer, right? And just after that we are printing successfully appended. That's it, right? With a slash. Now let me run this. Before running, we will close the file, right? Let me save it, and now let me run this and see what output you are getting. See, it is asking enter the content you want to append. So I am appending here hello Jenny, right? And enter, successfully appended. Let's see the file abc.txt. See, first of all, in this abc.txt, what was the content? Welcome to Jenny's lectures, hi, hello, and hello Jenny has been appended. Now this is our actual file. Now let me run this file again, and we will add some more content, like which content you want to append. Jayanti Khatri, right? And run and successfully appended. So let me just show you this file. See, after hello Jenny, now Jayanti Khatri. So previous content is also there, and we have added new content, right? But in the same line. So same you can use, rather than fputs, if you use fprintf, then fp is not in this, simply fp, then slash n percentage s, and here you can provide the str, the name of the variable in which the content is there, rather than fputs. I am using now fprintf, right? Now let me just run this again. See, it is asking enter the content you want to append. So I love India, successfully appended, and now let me just show you the file. See, I love India, it is in new line. The previous content is also there, and we have added I love India, right? So that's it for this video. Now I'll see you in the next video. Till then, bye bye, take care.